Let's talk about what it takes for you to be able to speak to actual buyers versus people who are kind of interested, see your program as absolutely amazing, so needed, the thing I'm looking for, but I'm not really ready to buy. That's not who we want to talk to. And I want to walk you through the process behind what it really takes for you to attract people through your content, through your marketing, through your ads, through your podcast, through whatever it is that you're doing that are actually ready to take action and buy from you right now. So, you see, most programs out there are teaching people how to speak to problems. So, they teach you how to agitate the problem, how to make them feel like the problem is terrible and see you as their savior and like the person that's going to come in and really save them from the situation. It's all about problem, problem, problem. However, what I want you to understand is that buyers don't see themselves in that way. They don't see themselves as victims to situations. Like they're not coming from a place of victim mentality. And I was thinking about this morning because I am definitely somebody personally who doesn't see herself as somebody who's a victim mentality person at all, right? And I have a quote unquote bleeding neck problem in a way, but I also don't. I don't see my life as a bleeding neck. So I'll explain what I mean. I am the person that is financially responsible for everybody that lives in my house. We are seven people in my house. My husband works with me. We have three kids, and my in-laws live with us as well. So I am financially responsible for seven people. We're like the typical Latino family over here. When you consider that, you would think that because of this, it means that anything related to me making more money in my business is a bleeding neck problem. But I don't see my life as a bleeding neck problem. I see obstacles as obstacles. I see challenges as normal life business challenges that anybody will have. And when I have a problem in my business or something isn't working correctly or I'm not hitting my goals or whatever, I'm not like panicking, looking to who can save me. I'm more focused on, okay, what do I need to do next? What do I need to focus on? Where is the problem? What's the thing I need to do? Who do I need to hire? Where do I invest? How do I move forward to get to the next step? I don't see myself as this poor victim that has like my life is falling apart and I'm desperate. I find that people who are desperate are typically not always the right fit because if you are desperate, you tend to be hopeless. And if you're hopeless, it's so much harder for you to be convinced that there's a solution available. Even if you have the money, it's a lot harder because you're like, I don't know if this will work. And everything feels harder. So your job as a marketer, as a coach, is going to be much more difficult, to overcome objections because you're speaking to people who are already hopeless, right? So buyers don't see themselves like that. They don't see themselves as these like hopeless fools who are like, I usually tell my clients like disempowered idiots that are like, oh my God, my life is falling apart. Nothing is working, right? It's like more like, let's go. Let's solve the problem. Let's move forward. Sorry about the loud clap. So what I want to talk about is kind of like a few different layers that are underneath the problem and how to speak to buyers that are really important. So first, let's talk about people because most of these programs are out there. Most of the marketers, again, I was saying a moment ago, are focused on teaching you how to speak to the problem. What is the problem? Let's figure out the problem. Let's market to the problem. Let's agitate the problem. Let's make people feel like crap, the whole thing. But they don't paint a clear picture on who the person behind the problem is. And what you have to understand is that there are different levels of awareness. You've probably heard this before. There's different levels of awareness. There's people that are problem unaware, so they don't even know they have a problem. There's people that are problem aware. They recognize that they have a problem. They just don't know what the solution is. There's people that are solution aware, and those are people that know the problem. They know that there's a solution, and they're just trying to figure out if your solution is the solution for them. And then there's people that are product aware, who are like, they know your solution, they want it, they're in all the things. And what happens is that most people are kind of not really taking people through the journey of having them be problem aware, solution aware, all of these like that different process in their content. But the most important thing that you have to understand about buyers is that whether they're problem unaware or they're solution aware or whatever the situation is, these are people that need to be self-aware. These are people who are able to recognize, okay, I need to make a change. I need to fix things, or I need to move forward, or I'm going to do whatever it takes to be able to fix the situation or change, right? These are people that are willing to change. They have to be willing to change. If they're not willing to change, they're not willing to do the work, they're not willing to commit, they're not willing to invest, well, then it's going to be harder for you to sell it to those people, as you can imagine, right? So when we look at buyers, these are people who can see a problem as, okay, there's this obstacle in the middle right now, and I'm going to go and fix it, instead of the people that are falling apart. Now, does it work to sell to the people that are falling apart? Sure, it can work. You can sell, you can very well build your entire business around paid marketing and making people feel like crap and making them feel like you're their savior, the whole thing, if that's your thing. I personally would like to make my life easier. I would rather speak to people who are already doing good. Okay. So instead of speaking to people that are really bad and taking like in a bad place and taking them to be good, I like to speak to people who are doing okay or doing good and taking them to a place of being great. And so that is the difference between you speaking to buyers versus you speaking to, okay, somebody who's like falling apart, right? So, you know, let's talk a little bit more about who these buyers are, because buyers for me are people who are willing to change. They're willing to invest in solving the problem. They're willing to commit. And really, for me, one of the most important things is that these are people who are willing to shift their identity to become the person that doesn't have that problem anymore. And this is important too, because like, let's use weight loss as an example, right? With weight loss, there's a lot of women, I'm going to use women as an example, although I'm sure men as well. But anyways, that are like, I've been a dieter my whole life. I've been in a diet my whole life. And this is part of, this is my identity. This is who I am. So being somebody who's not in a diet anymore and becoming the person who doesn't even worry about their weight anymore is a big stretch for somebody who's not willing to shift their identity to become that new person. So if you're selling to the person who is always the dieter and that's who they are and they don't want to change that who they are as their identity, it's so much harder for you to get these people to buy from you, right? So we have to really go deeper into understanding, well, what makes somebody an actual buyer, right? And speaking more about their desires, we do need to use problems though. I want to make this very clear. I'm not saying go out there and just use desires and vision and inspiration of who you want to be. You have to speak to problems, but always in the context of who the person who's ready to buy is that has this problem, if that makes sense, right? So again, like most people are not painting a clear picture behind who these people are, who the person behind the problem is. You want to ask yourself, what makes somebody an ideal client? What makes them a buyer? What makes them somebody who's ready to move forward? In my 20-minute training, I actually go deeper into this and I give more specific examples. If you haven't watched it yet, go to readytoinvestclients.com to watch it, right? But you know, what you want to make sure that you're doing through your content is making sure that you're calling in these buyers and you're taking them from the process of being problem unaware to being like, I'm ready to buy from you, right? Because not everybody that's going to necessarily come into your funnels, your content or whatever is going to be immediately ready to buy. But the intention is to turn your people into ready to buy people by calling in the buyer through your content. I know that this is kind of like an abstract concept that I'm explaining here, but that's what I really, really see behind the process, right? So in my own content, I do this consistently. I'm always walking people through who they need to be and how they need to show up to be able to get results, right? And so also a big part of that is understanding, well, who is my buyer? Who is the person that is ready to invest in working with me? Because, you know, and I'm creating content that speaks to these people because I understand that my ideal client is focused on the payoff, not the payment. They're not worried about how, like paying me money or some crazy thing. That's not how they act. That's not how they see the world. So I create content to these people. My job is not trying to convince anybody of hiring me. I know that this sounds weird because you might be thinking, well, Fabi, I don't understand. Aren't you supposed to? No, like if you feel like you don't understand why messaging is an issue ever at all and why it's valuable to work on your messaging, well, then you might not be the person for me at all, right? There has to be some sort of awareness that messaging is a good thing. It's kind of like if you're trying to convince people, like, here's why coaching is going to be helpful for you. If you have to tell people why coaching is helpful for them, it's very unlikely that they're the right audience, even if they are problem unaware, right? They still need to be able to value coaching or value investing in one way or another, right? So in my case, I'm not trying to convince anybody in hiring me. I'm trying to show them why what I do works. And I'm speaking to buyers through everything. And I do that by proving to people that I understand their problem, right? So the most important thing that you can do to attract buyers is to learn how to speak to people and their problems that they have in a way that brings them in. Not doing what I call the Ursula, which is speaking to the poor, unfortunate souls, where you're just agitating the problem and the pain, right? So if you're telling people like you're hopeless and your life is falling apart and you're full of anxiety and you can't sleep at night and you feel like, oh, I can't breathe, it's very unlikely that that person that is in that level of being desperate is actually going to be ready to hire you, right? But also, we don't want to take it to the extreme of creating content that people are like, oh my God, this is so inspiring. Like, I love it. I love it. This is amazing, right? But then they don't take action. So you have to figure out how to move your audience and activate buyers, asking yourself, who do you need to be for this? Like, how do you need to show up? And how do you become a match to their level of power? And, you know, it's very hard for you to make consistent sales that are not excessively expensive if you don't figure out how to speak to buyers, how to sell your idea to these people, because that needs to be at the core. I call that the angle of mastery. It's like, what is your big idea? What is the big thing that you're selling? One of the things that I notice happens a lot with funnels and webinars and VSLs or emails or content is that people are very much focused on selling the call. I want to get you on the call. I want to get you to book the call. And I'm doing everything I can to get people on the phone to the strategy session or whatever, but you're not really selling the idea. If you want to attract buyers and you want to speak to buyers, there has to be depth in what you're sharing. There has to be a difference in how you, like, in how you're explaining things that is not the same thing that everybody else is saying in exactly the same way and whatever, right? And so part of this, I know that I'm talking a lot today and I'm talking fast because I'm excited. Like, this is like lights me up. I could talk about this for days, by the way, in case you have not noticed, right? So for me, part of it is that you want to really understand the problem in a way that is unique and different, right? And one of the issues that I see happening very often is that people don't understand how to speak to the problem when we're talking to buyers and even when we're not talking to buyers, right? So you're saying things like, well, or more than you're saying things, like you have to understand that there's a difference between how you view their problem versus how they view their problem, right? So you might see it as like, oh, your nervous system isn't regulated. That's your problem. And you're creating content all about like, how you're a somatic coach for nervous system regulation. Literally, I had a client that was this when she came in and worked with me. And that was her whole message. Like, I'm going to help you regulate your nervous system through somatic methods or whatever it was. And I was like, what? I have no clue what this means. Like, you're talking to me in another language. I don't understand any of it, right? Because oftentimes you feel like, well, obviously, as the expert I am, I'm talking to the problem. I understand very clearly what the problem is. But what you need to be doing is speaking to people, specifically to buyers, again, painting a clear picture around who the buyer is, speaking to their problems in a way that they will understand it. So instead of like your nervous system isn't regulated and we need to do somatic coaching or whatever, you can see it as, well, like, you know, every time you're about to give a presentation, you feel like you're about to throw up no matter how prepared you are. And you're so nervous when your boss calls you in, you feel like you're going to fall apart. There's imposter syndrome. There's thoughts of, I'm not like, did I do a good job? Am I in trouble? All of these things are coming up. And I feel like I am so afraid that I don't even want to move forward. Or I would probably not say that, but it's like, I'm afraid that I'm going to get fired or whatever that is, right? So it's about how do you communicate to people where they are at? And again, more specifically, speak to buyers where they're at. Again, there's a difference between the people that have the problem who are ready to buy and ready to solve it versus the people that are like, I have the problem, but I have no way of getting out of here. Like, there's no way. I can't invest. I don't have time. I like, come in and save me. You do the work or whatever, right? So what happens is that people don't know the difference and don't know how to communicate effectively to buyers. Buyers see the world different. And if you're creating content that is just focused on selling a call, or you're just focused on talking to the problem and agitating the problem and making people feel like crap, you're not going to attract buyers. I mean, maybe one in 10 or 20 are like, okay, they're a buyer and they came in because luckily they resonated with something that made sense. But then the rest of your time, your precious hours of the day are filled with conversations and calls with people that are a great fit, but they don't buy. And this is another whole issue around people who are like, well, Fabi, I attract a lot of people who are great fits. They're perfect. They're perfect candidates. Are they enrolling? Well, no, but they're great fits. Well, if they're not enrolling, they're not great fits. They're either buying or they're not buying. And if the great majority of people are not buying and they're bringing up objections and they can't afford it, well, then you're not speaking to the right audience, because the right audience should buy. Like, if they're consuming your content and they're clicking on the link and they're booking the call, they're finding a spot, they're filling out the form, they're showing up to the call and telling you, I can't buy, that's not your audience. Those are not your people. I mean, obviously you're not going to have 100% close rate, but it should be a nice, decent number if you're speaking to the right people. Yes, you might have less calls booked, but wouldn't you rather have more time than spend all day long on the phone with people who are not going to buy? Anyways, all of this to say that you need to learn how to shift your content, your marketing, your message, your way of showing up to speak to actual buyers, to speak to people who are here to take action, who are committed to having that vision realized, committed to their goals. That's what you need to be focusing on, instead of just talking to anybody and everybody and let me get people on the phone. Great, good for you. Your phone is like, your calendar is filled up. Do you have a life at all? Is that what you want for yourself? Is that like what you view like, oh, okay, because you had your calls booked, if you're running ads that are like $100, great. How much does it cost you to actually make a sale, right? Because you're speaking to so many of the wrong people. How much time do you have to create, to feel in alignment, to show up, to build content, to show up for your clients, to have a life, to go out to the park? How much time do you have? Is that what you want? Ideally, I would imagine that you do want to speak to buyers. So here's how I can help you. We can, you and me, not me and my team, not me and my assistant, you and I can get on a 15-minute call where I can take a look at your message. That means your marketing, that means your landing page, that means your webinar, that means your website, that means your content, whatever you want to show me. And I can tell you if you're already speaking to buyers, and if you're not, what you need to shift in your specific message, like you specifically, to be able to speak to buyers. This is not a scripted call. The only script is like the first minute of the call, and that's it. The rest of it is me literally evaluating your message and telling you, my friend, this right here is not attracting buyers because of this, this, and that. And if you want to speak to buyers, you need to do this, this, and that. So I will tell you and I will give you the actual answer so that you can attract more buyers, because I would imagine that at the end of the day, that is what you want. So if you want that, go to brandmessagesession.com to book it, or find the links below this episode to be able to book that call with me. Make sure that you are subscribed on YouTube, on Apple Podcasts, or on Spotify. And please leave me the questions that you have below this video or this audio, depending on where you're listening or watching, about buyers. How do you speak to buyers? Leave me any questions that you have or any requests for future episodes as well. I hope that this was helpful, and I will see you soon.